Hi, Mike Redding here from usingtechnologybetter.com. In today's video, I'm going to show you how we can use some of the best features of Google Classroom and Teacher Dashboard together so that we can get the best results and outcomes for our students. Now, when we use Google Classroom, one of the greatest features of Classroom is being able to easily set assessment tasks for our students and then be able to have those students turn those assessment tasks in. The one piece that's missing for me in that ability to do that is the ability to easily see what the students are working on, especially if they're using individual documents. If I had 30 students, what I would need to do is have 30 tabs open with each of those documents in there and just be able to see what those students are doing. Now, as a teacher, I want to be proactive and I want to be able to find the students who are falling behind, maybe who are disengaged, maybe who are just struggling with the question or are otherwise distracted. And so it can be a little bit cumbersome using Google Drive and Classroom to just stay on top of all that work, especially if you're a high school teacher and you've got multiple students across multiple days. But here we've also got the ability to use Teacher Dashboard. Now, Teacher Dashboard enables us to see all of our students' work all on one screen from inside a class. And so it's a great feature to be able to easily interact with our students and find out how they're getting on. So here's the way that I would use Classroom and Teacher Dashboard together. So you might have a particular assignment or a document that you want to send to your students. And so what you would do is you would put in your assignment here. And from here, we would want to attach the document that you would want to assign to your students. Now, when you assign this document, it's going to show up in their Google Classroom folder inside their Drive account. But you'll have access to see each of those students' work because they are shared back to you with a teacher. But once again, you're going to have multiple documents open at the same time to be able to see how that goes. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to say that these students can view the file because I don't want it to be a collaborative document. And in fact, let's just make a copy for each student. So I'm going to assign that document to those students. It's just going to work it into the background. And then if I go and have a look as if I'm a student, what will happen is if they go to their stream just here, what will happen is that you'll have an assignment that will show up here for those particular students. Now, that student can open that document, they can work in it. Here it is just here. Look at that for a spelling mistake. And they can open that document. Now, as I said, if your students are working in that document, what you could do as a teacher is you could come back to your particular Drive account here. You could open up that there, and you would be able to see this as your students open it and then be able to interact with those students. So there's student one who has it open. Let's have a look for student two. So let's go back to their stream account. So student two now opens a document. When they open it, the document is actually created for them. And so if I go back to my Drive account just here, you'll see that that student will now have appeared. So there it is just there. And so I would have to have this document here for Ashley open, and I'd also have to have this document here open so I could see this student as well. Now, what I would do in terms of workflow for the students is I would say to the student, once they've got this document open here, that I would say to the students, what I want you to do is I want to take this document and I want you to add it to the class folder that was created during Teacher Dashboard. So when Teacher Dashboard is set up, then you are able to see and access the students' work inside that folder. So I would say to the students, what I want you to do is I'd click here, move to folder, and I would say, please put it into your English folder. All right, so once you have your student who has put their document inside the English folder, then I can come back to my Teacher Dashboard account just here, and I can see that this is the document from Ashley, and then Kyle would have his document there, Trisha would have her document there, and once again, I could just hover over it to get an idea of what they've done, and I could simply click that link just there, which would open up a new tab for me, and it would give me access straight into this account just here. So with this now, what I'm able to do is have all of my students' work all on one screen, but I'm still able to interact with those students and keep abreast of what they're doing. So I love both features of Classroom and Teacher Dashboard, but I love the way that they can work together so well. The one thing to notice about this is when your student comes back in and they turn in that document just here, for you as a teacher, if I go back to my Teacher Dashboard account and just refresh that, what you'll find is that the document would have been removed from your Teacher Dashboard view. Okay, so basically, once the document is inside your English folder, the students work in it, when a student returns that document to you, it takes it out of the English folder and puts it back into the Google Classroom folder, which is a really great feature. So if you have any questions about how you can use Google Classroom and Teacher Dashboard together, or if you'd like a free trial of Teacher Dashboard, then just simply send an email to the email address that's on the bottom of your screen right now, right inside the video, and one of the help team will contact you and get that process started for you.